Hello, I'm Lorna Steele. I work as a curator for the Natural History Museum in London, but I've recently become curator of the Radnorshire Museum too. It's a small museum in the Welsh county of Powys, run by the county council. The collections range from archaeology to social history, with everything else in between. The museum is in the small town of Llandrindod-Wells. The building opened in 1911 as a free public library, but also housed a modest display of archaeological material from the nearby Roman fort Castle Colon. The discovery of an ancient logboat in the River Ithon in 1929 inspired the founding of the Llandrindod-Wells Museum, which shared the library building. In 1971, the library vacated the building, allowing the museum to expand. Prior to my appointment in March 2021, the museum had been without a curator for about 2 years. Admission is currently free, but donations are appreciated. Like most county museums, the Radnorshire Museum contains some natural history items but does not specialise in natural history. It contains finds from archaeological sites, metalwork, pottery, wooden objects, stone tools and so on. One of the most remarkable objects on display is the Sheelana gig, a stone carving of a naked female figure exposing her genitalia. This was found buried under the floor in a local church and is believed to be 11th century. It's one of only three Sheelas found in Wales and the largest and best preserved of all of them. There are also a few objects from elsewhere in the world that were donated prior to the existence of a proper acquisition policy. This cabinet of curiosities contains a very strange mix of natural history and ethnography, which is very popular with visitors. There's a small number of taxidermy birds, mammals and fish representing the local wildlife. But the highlight of this museum is the local fossil collection. It's worth describing this in more detail. The rocks of the local area were deposited during the Middle Ordovician around 460 million years ago and record the formation and erosion of a volcanic island complex. The rocks contain well-preserved fossil organisms, which have been studied in great detail over the past 300 years. The insights gained into Ordovician paleobiology here in Mid Wales are of global significance. The local geology is explained in some detail on text panels and labels in the cases. The different formations are described and illustrated by a range of fossils from those strata. There are illustrations showing reconstructions of the seabed 460 million years ago, with all the weird and wonderful animals brought back to life. Visitors can also use a binocular microscope to examine a selection of local fossils. These geology displays were created with input from local experts Joe Botting and Lucy Muir, who publicise local geology on their website, www.asoldasthehills.org. They also run a local geology group that meets monthly at the museum. Welcome to the storeroom. It has two rows of open shelving, one row is fixed shelving and one row is compactorised roller racking to save space. A collections review in 2014 identified certain items for potential disposal, but recognised the importance of the fossil collection, thank goodness. It's likely that disposal will focus on large items in the social history collection. Then the store will be reorganised, which will enable me to locate objects easily when planning temporary displays. I've made a bid for storage materials and containers. I want to improve our permanent displays and temporary exhibitions to generate more visitors. There will be a consultation to find out what visitors would like to see in future in the museum. The Friends of the Museum group will be invited to take part in this. There's a new website for Powys Museums in development as part of an overall digital transformation for the County Council. Curators have a great deal of input into developing our museum web pages, and we're encouraged to use social media to promote the museums. And to help with this, we'll be advertising a short-term position for a curatorial assistant. Keep your eye on the Powys County Council jobs website if you might be interested. Looking ahead, I want to develop partnerships and projects with other museums. Our contact details are here on the last slide. Thanks for listening, and bye for now.